Shake that.
I came to live life out loud, and I think from that literary genius, there's probably few words that sum up what we all do. We should always remember that the reason that all of us have our rights and our justice is not because of powerful people or famous people or something outside of ourselves. The reason that we have full and equal rights today as gay and lesbian and transgender people is for one simple group of courageous people. The people who said, I and we and not they and them when they spoke about gay and lesbian, transgender, bisexual and queer people. And when they said I and we, rather than choosing to say they and them, they were beaten up. And you remember, for many of us who were in the Toronto Gay Patrol, there were blood in the laneways of the village when the bachelors came. They were young kids who at 14 and 15 found themselves on the street when their parents shoved them out the door. They were generations of great young gay workers, lesbian and transgender, mature workers, who when they came out of the closet, lost their apartment, lost their partner, and lost their jobs. They were in the middle of the AIDS crisis, people who came out as they had AIDS and didn't get the benefits, didn't get into the hospital room to say goodbye to their friends. Those were the great acts of courage that are going on in Nigeria, Uganda, Iran, and Russia, where people are being beaten up, killed, denied, having their families broken up. So it is a huge celebration of what we've accomplished in Canada and in other countries, but it is a sobering reminder that our activism isn't ending, and it isn't. Our future and our destiny isn't in the hands of other people. It's in our hearts, and it's in our courage. There's two ways, I think, that we as queer people have learned to live our lives. You either live your life for the people you're afraid of and the things you fear, or you live your life for the people you love and the things you hope for. You dance in the sunshine or you hide in the shadows, and we are about to dance in the sunshine like we never have before for people here and around the world. And as the first queer guy getting elected as a mayor anywhere in the world, I want to thank you. I also want to recognize that two of my colleagues are here, big supporters. Han Dong, the new elected MPP-elect for Trinity Spadina, whose constituents we are, and my friend Peter Tavins, the MPP for Toronto Danforth. Thank you very much for both of you being out here. Let's get out and walk it. Let's have some fun. I'm a Tom Robinson band junkie, so I am so excited. I even have my vinyl record. My dream is I get Tom to sign it. And as the first queer mayor in the world, the first head of state in the Commonwealth, our Premier Kathleen Wynne, who sends you her enormous thanks for her election, is waiting for us in Nathan Phillips Square. From the old gay guy to our brand new, the first woman. We've only been voting for 200 years. We finally elected a woman, and she's a fabulous out lesbian. And on behalf of Jane and Kathleen and the entire Liberal team, and indeed all my conservative NDP friends at Queen's Park, God bless, keep you safe. Let's go have a kick-ass party and change the world.